Okay, so now obviously we're going to want to put in some block labels into this map, and it's a fairly simple process. So we go to the layer here, we right click on it, and then we go to style, or we go to properties rather, click on that, and then we go to this tab here for labels, and then so we're going to do single labels. And we're going to want a label with the block name, obviously. And we go ahead and we click apply. And you can see it looks really jumbled up. So what you're going to have to do is you're going to tell it where you want the labels to go. And so we're going to do offset from centroid. And then offset from centroid, it's looking really solid. Obviously we're missing labels in here for blocks number 17 and 18, 20, and then so these really small blocks. We can do things like in here we can, you know, make the text smaller, and then we can start to see the block numbers in some of these areas are popping up because you just need it to be small enough. So that now we can see all of the block numbers, but you can see it's incredibly small. So what we're going to need to do is create a create callout labels for some of these small blocks, and this is kind of a unique thing for Shemeketa. You may find callout labels useful in other applications for other things, but obviously, like in this vineyard, we've got a bunch of really small blocks where the callout label is something that we're going to need to do. So, I will, in order to do that, we're going to create, another layer. So you go to create layer and then create shapefile layer. And so let's do block number 17. So we'll just call this one block 17. Rear your head back and roar. We're gonna make a point, and again we'll just use the UTM zone 10. And then we're gonna create a new field in here, and it's going to be called, let's call it block, and then add field, and get rid of that ID, and then click OK. It's kind of fun for a guy like me, sitting here in your shop. And then we're going to click toggle editing, and then add point, and we'll go ahead and add this point at the vertex here of block 17. Go ahead and call block 17 in there, click OK. And so now we have a block 17 point. And then we're going to use this to now create our call out. So we go ahead and we click on the block 17 point, go to properties, and then we go to this layer here, the symbology thing, and then we're going to create a geometry layer. So what we do is just hit this green arrow, this green cross, and now it's creating a layer above the, so you can see the gray point there. And you can see the gray there. So this layer is above that. We want to reverse that order. So click on the gray dot and then move it up. All right. And then here, we're going to create a geometry. It's called the geometry layer or geometry generator. And then now in the geometry generator, we're going to first we're going to do, make it geometry type is going to be line string / multi-string. And we're going to get rid of this formula. And we're going to replace it with this formula. And this is in the document in the tutorial. So you can just copy and paste that. And then you can see now we're creating a line in here. And for this, we can make it the same color. We can make the line the same color as the field if we wanted to. And how we would go about doing that is just going to color, pick color, and then we go and I'm gonna have to move it off to the side of the screen to do this, but pick color, and then you make this little dropper thing, and we'll choose the color within the field. So I'll do it off the side of the screen here. Okay, so now that color has been chosen. And for the that gray dot up there, we don't actually need that to be there, so we can just make that transparent. So just stroke fill color, hit transparent fill, stroke color, hit transparent stroke, click apply, okay. And then also, so go back to properties. Also, we're gonna wanna put in the label, so no labels, then a single label, and then we use the block, hit apply, and there you go. So now you've got your label, and if you use this is the move. This is the move label, and we're gonna use this. Okay, and there you go. So now you can see we have formed we've done the call out for that. Okay. So we can just keep doing that on the other blocks as well. one thing to note that you can also do is you can rotate as you move this thing around. You can also rotate the label. So if you need to rotate things, you can go ahead and do that by clicking on that icon right there, rotate label. So now I'm going to go through and I'm going to do that for the other blocks.